Motz Office.
Hey, Carter, I just got your phone message there. This is Tom from Community TV in Medicine Hat.
Hi. So Glenn had a few minutes a little bit earlier, and so he wanted me to reach out to you. Are you available later in the week, like Friday morning or early next week?
Sure, yeah, whenever he calls back. I'm working on another story that's probably really big. In fact, the conservatives are going to love this story. Not a lot of people know about it yet. I'll give you a little bit of quick background. In 1997, a guy from Iraq moved here to Canada as like a refugee status, became citizen. Turns out that he actually was connected to the mafia in Iraq and killed somebody there, and that's why he moved over here. Once he got here, he ran for the Liberal Party of Canada in 2017. There's pictures of him close to Justin Trudeau. There's pictures of him with a bunch of other Liberal Party people. He committed immigration fraud against people back in Iraq to the tune of $300,000 and got one person over here in a case that might be considered human trafficking. So,
really?
Yeah, this is going to be a huge story real soon. And it just broke out a little old Medicine Hat because of a gas war that happened in Walsh. In little old Walsh, Alberta, there's two gas stations, and Anwar Kamaran owned one of these gas stations. The guy across the street, Jeff Shoesmith, had been there for a couple years, and he really didn't like the guy across the street, so they started dipping the gas prices just to see if they could get him out of town. This guy was able to dip gas prices so low that it was, like, incredible. Like, where is he getting this money? How is he losing money on gas like this? And then they started fighting, and the guy, Anwar Kamaran, went across the street and punched Jeff in the face. He got arrested, and he went to jail for a little bit, but he was released because, they got to wait until due process. While he was out, he was threatening the family and saying, I'll mess you up again. So he got arrested again, and the judge said, you're not getting out until your trial, which is in July. And so while he's in jail, all of a sudden, all these victims of this fraud start coming forward and contacting me here in Medicine Hat and saying, this guy is mafia connected. He's threatened to kill people in Canada. He's threatened to kill people in Iraq. He's done deals with the mafia in Iraq for trucking equipment in Canada and all kinds of crazy. This is a big story. So I do want to talk to Glenn still about Bill C-10 and why it's important that small broadcasters still are able to do investigative journalism like this. But I think this particular case outlines the exact reason why we need Bill C-10 amendments so that small broadcasters like me can continue to investigate stories like this without being somehow stopped by the CRTC. Because maybe, I don't know, the Liberal Party doesn't want small journalists to poke around. I'm just one dude who's just trying to make it in Medicine Hat, and I've been selling advertising all by myself to local advertisers, and, there's no handout at all for the small guy, you know? It's like, I see there is some disparity there, and I think it's really worth talking about, but this other case is also really worth talking about. Maybe Glen Motz wants to bring it up in the House. How was Anwar Kamaran able to run for the Liberal Party of Medicine Hat in Medicine Hat Cardston Warner in 2017 after having committed these frauds and people having reported to the government before this? Like, these people in 2017 went to the government and said, hey, this guy is threatening to kill us, and, you know, he was still able to run for the Liberal Party here somehow. So I just want to email you the link on the latest video of that, just in case you guys are interested. It's just like less than 15 minutes and outlines the entire story if you want to, you know,
Sure, yeah. Shoot
it around the office or whatever. What's your email?
It's glen.motz.
Oh, right. No, I have that. Just call it Anwar Kamaran, the name of the guy there. Ran for Libs in 2017.
Okay.
There's a link there.
Great. Yeah, it'll probably be Friday morning now before Glenn has time, but I'll pass that on to him.
Sweet. Thanks so much for your help, man.
Yep, no problem.
Have a good one.
Cheers.
Right? That could be kind of juicy.